and technical staff, press and media, parents, and all of our beloved graduates to the graduation ceremony. I request all of you to please maintain silence. Graduation, a conclusion of one chapter, a beginning of another. It is an honor to witness this exhilarating event, the high point of the academic year. Talent and skills are the crops that are nurtured, groomed, and given all possible opportunities to grow and bloom. Graduation day is the celebration of the harvest of this crop. This is a much-awaited event in every student's life, as today truly signifies the culmination of many years of hard work in the relentless pursuit of knowledge. Knowledge that will enable the student to embrace opportunities and take on challenges with clear vision and purpose. Graduation day at Bangalore Institute of Technology is a day full of joy, a day about pride and accomplishment, a day of celebration. Thousands of graduates spanning 38 batches have graduated from Bangalore Institute of Technology since its inception in the year 1979. Every coming year, we the staff at BIT look forward to this exhilarating event with great joy to celebrate the accomplishment and academic achievements of our beloved students. This year, it is twice the joy for us as we have with us two outgoing batches in this graduation ceremony. Hurdles come in many forms. COVID-19 is ours. But we have endured, we have overcome, and we are better for it. Today, let us join together in celebrating this graduation day, laying aside the academic impediments imposed by the viral pandemic, and embrace this pinnacle of excellence, this moment of triumph, with great pride. Ladies and gentlemen, I once again request you all, graduation ceremony is a ceremony of high regard. I request all of you to please maintain silence and embrace this event with great respect. It is mark of our tradition to invoke the Almighty at the beginning of an important event. To begin this auspicious occasion, may I invite Ms. Navyashree K. Umesha, student, Department of Civil Engineering, to invoke the Almighty.
Baro yena kanda purandhara Krishnayani Baraya, Krishnayani Baraya.
Thank you. Initiate the graduation ceremony. May I now request all to please rise for our Nadagite.
Oh,
I would now like to invite our beloved principal, Dr. Ashwath MU, for the welcome speech.
Good morning. I know after a long time all of you are meeting, you are super excited, lot of things to discuss, but I request all of you to maintain silence till the proceedings of the graduation day completes and you can enjoy till evening. All arrangements are made in the campus for taking your selfies, photographs, photo wall is also arranged. So I request all of you to maintain silence during the proceedings. In fact, for the two batches, we have clubbed to organize this graduation day because of the reasons that all of you know, COVID-19, we could not do the graduation day ceremony on time. But a lot of students start sending emails and requesting for this program. Even now, the SOPs are not completely lifted. I request all of you to maintain the standard operating procedures during the process. And this program has been organized with lot of precautions, including sanitizing all your gowns and other things. Every part is taken care, and you can be safe in the campus. All arrangements are done as per the guidelines of the ministries. I welcome all of you once again to this program, all the graduates of the two batches and the parents and teachers for this program. Long-awaited program. I know the graduates, some of you have already started working and some of you are about to start. And a round of applause for today's chief guest. He is going to give you a lot of tips. Sri P.B. Kotur is the global head of Wipro for freshers engagement. I think you will give a lot of tips for all of you how to get transition from campus to the corporate and how to spend your freshest early days in the corporate, which will decide your future in the career. As all of us know, in the last few years, especially from last 3 years, we are talking about the new education policy, the employability, and the skills required for the future. And the various stakeholders, that is universities, AICTE, NASSCOM, and all the ministries have taken a lot of initiatives in giving training to you need to maintain silence. To skill the graduates and the future skill requirements, NASSCOM has also taken a lot of initiatives. And many other organizations, wherever you go, the major organizations have spent a lot of efforts in training the graduates of the future. This is the Super Skills program of NASSCOM, which was launched in 2017. And it gives complete details about the skills required for the future. I think you are still in the early days of your career in the industry. If you want to succeed, you need to learn a lot of skills required in this direction. About 70 plus job roles have been identified, which will rule the world in the next coming few years. At least next 10 years, these kind of jobs will definitely rule the market. And if you want to be successful, successful and if you want to be relevant in this industry, you need to upgrade your skills. Whatever you have learned in the engineering will only give you as the basics. And in the industry, if you want to survive, if you want to excel, you need to upgrade yourselves by self-learning skills. There are a lot of professional skills requirements, and the continuous learning is the need of the hour. Every day you need to keep learning the requirement of the industry, and there are a lot of organizations available for training. Online certification programs are also available so that you can upgrade yourself in these areas. And at BIT, as all of you know, we have created a lot of clubs. 30 plus clubs are there to develop the various inherent potentials of the students, both technical as well as other non-curricular activities. And recently we have initiated about Center of Excellence in all the departments, and these Centers of Excellence will be available for all of you. Even after your graduation, you can come back and work in these Centers of Excellence and avail the facilities of the excellence. And we also have a lot of companies visiting, and we have signed in the last 3 years more than 113 companies. We have signed the MOUs where opportunities are available for both present students and passed out students to interact with them and do on various project works. And recently, this is very important for all of you. Recently, we have started initiative on virtual mentoring platform using our alumni network. There are thousands of alumni passed out from this BIT, and almost about 372 alumni have come forward to mentor the freshers in the industry. It is very difficult to survive in the first few years in the industries unless you have proper mentoring. And this virtual mentoring platform, headed with Ajit Prabhakar, Somik Raha, Charles John and Vidya Vaidyanathan, they have taken the initiative and they will create a platform where all of you can get mentors from the industry who have 10 plus years of experience, so that they will guide you for whatever requirement you need in the industry. And I'm very happy that all the alumni of BIT are doing very well, both nationally and at international levels. Many of them in the last few years ventured into entrepreneurship and startups. Some of them are doing very well. I'm just showing some sample alumni here so that you can get motivation from these people, and you can also start excelling in the startup circle, because the government policies are also very attractive for the startup. And I'm very happy all these people have started visiting BIT for recruitment process for their companies. They've already recruited several students from BIT. And we have signed an MOU with one alumni company, Mistral Solutions. They've extended all the supports for the Center of Excellence at BIT. And this is very interesting, and very happy to share that many of our alumni in the last 2 years, because of this COVID-19, there are a lot of service requirement to mitigate the pandemic. And many of our alumni have jumped in immediately to the service mode, and they have created a lot of facilities. Ravi Machani is one person you must be knowing. In the initial days, there were a lot of fear. At that time, they have created oxygen fitted bus, and he is one of the team member, and another one is Mr. Prashant Prakash. There are lots of alumni of BIT who have done a lot of contribution during the last 2 years, and I'm sure this will motivate all of you to not only working for self, but working for the society is also very, very important. And our alumni have excelled in all the areas, not only in technology, but in all other areas our alumni have excelled. I'm showing these tips to motivate you that opportunities are limitless. You have tremendous growth potential in the days to come, and it all depends on your self-learning capabilities. This is another person I was mentioning again and again. Prashant Prakash is the first startup person in India who initiated IoT related and internet based company called as Netcraft, and he is now the advisor to government of Karnataka on startups. So for this function, I welcome our administrator of Rajya Vakilera Sangha, Sri Kare Gowda. He will be joining shortly. And so the man of the day is Sri P.B. Kotur. I welcome sir for this program. And as all of you know, he is the head of Global Freshers Engagement Program. And he will be talking to you because there is a saying that initially wherever you spend your time, the first 5 to 6 years in whichever organization, whichever boss you are serving, that will decide the future of your career. So he will give you a lot of tips on Global Freshers Engagement, being head from so many years, and he is also head of growth market, skill development, work integrated learning programs, and he is also general manager. He is having multiple hats at present and taking care of lot of initiatives at Wipro and otherwise. Global Goodwill Ambassador, some of the awards he has won. He is also a popular author, educationalist, global talent transformer, motivational speaker, keynote speaker, and corporate leader. These are some of the earlier books that he has written. He was known in our days for C++ and computer science. He has also written a book in Kannada on computer science, one of the first book on computer science. And he is always very close to the student community. He goes wherever students are there and give a lot of initiatives. This is the photo where he is interacting with the students and assisting and launching the student app developed by the students of one of the engineering colleges. Many awards he has got. Lifetime Achievement Award, Sadhak, and Global Goodwill Ambassador, Best People Manager, Inspirational Leader, Social Learning Competition, Leadership Excellence Award, and Pet One, Dear Boss at his company for all his colleagues. And he is also popularly known for writing some short tags on Kannada and English. Keda Bhava, Beda Bhava, Cheda Bhava, Sada Kadami Agatha Bandali, the end. And we have for this program, I forgot to mention another thing. He is also head of Mission 10X, a not-for-profit initiative. This was one of the successful program Wipro did, training the trainers. And I'm very happy I was also part of this program. And the first program on Mission 10X was initiated and launched in BIT about 10 years back. First train the trainer program. And then they went on training thousands of students across the country. We have a guest of honor, Dr. C. Siddaramaya, KGS retired. He is the Chief Executive Officer of Rajya Vakilera Sangha. I welcome you, sir, for this graduation day. We expected another advisor, Rajya Vakilera Sangha, Dr. Narasimurthy K.H. He is also, along with the administrator, is there on an emergency. They may join any moment. I invite and welcome him for this program on behalf of all of you. So I remember one more point. Subrata Bakshi. How many of you know Subrata Bakshi? Yeah, he is a very popular writer, as well as he is one of the co-founder of Mindtree. And I'm very fortunate that he visited along with complete team of Mindtree, all the founders of Mindtree, and they spent one day in BIT Quadrangle interacting with all the young students. And he has written a few books, and I recommend strongly to all of you to read these books, The High Performance Entrepreneur, and the other book, Imagining India by Nandan Nilekani. These books will give you tips how to survive in the corporate world, and I strongly recommend all of you should read these books, few books, so that you will be more confident in handling your career. And lastly, during the interaction, Subrata Bakshi in the campus spoke to students, and he said one statement that his mother gave to Subrata: go kiss the world. That's the advice given to Subrata by his mother. And I, at this juncture, I invite all of you to join and read this book, and also I wish that all of you should go and kiss the world, so that the world will be a beautiful place to live in. And when you start interacting with the society, understanding the sentiments of the society and contributing to the welfare of the society, I think you will have a best time in your career. So in addition to career building, you also parallelly contribute to the social development and corporate social responsibility, contribute to that, and you will have a beautiful life. I wish you all the best once again, and thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your earnest welcome address. I extend my warm welcome to our respected principal, Dr. Ashwati MU, to the graduation ceremony. I welcome you, sir. A ray of light is a ray of hope. Let us all leave the darkness and step towards the bright path. Now we shall have the auspicious lamp lighting ceremony as a tribute to Mother Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. I now request the dignitaries on the dais to light the lamp and symbolically inaugurate this program. As techno-savvies and business grads, people's lives depend on our work. A graduation pledge is a commitment that will remind you to take pride in your work and do what's best for the community. May I now invite Professor Smita Yayan, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, to lead the graduates in reciting the graduation pledge.
I request all the students to stand up, the graduates to stand up and hold their hands forward to take the oath. And please repeat it immediately after me. As a student of Bangalore Institute of Technology and graduate of Visvesvaraya Technological University, I take this oath. I solemnly pledge myself to dedicate my life to the service of humanity. I'll be loyal to the profession of engineering and management, and generous to its members. I'll keep away from corruption and tempting others to vicious practice. I'll not use my professional knowledge contrary to the laws of humanity. I'll endeavor to avoid waste and consumption of non-renewable resources. I'll give my teachers, institute and university, the respect and gratitude for all the efforts bestowed on us. I take this pledge freely and upon my honor.
Thank you, graduates, and thank you very much, ma'am. It is my distinct privilege to invite the esteemed chief guest, Sri P.B. Kotur, Head, Global Freshers Engagement Program, Wipro Limited, Global Goodwill Ambassador, to address the August gathering.
Thank you, madam. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So that's the spirit and voice of BIT students. Yes? I'm sorry, some of you are not able to hear me and see me as well. But if you're not audible, please raise hands. I'm sure that I'm audible. Okay. First and foremost, hearty congratulations to all of you who are graduated in the last financial academic year and current year passing by. May I request all the graduates to just stand up, both the batches. It's not for the pledge, for something else. Now, without making a noise, thank you so much. Okay. Oh, thank you very much. Yeah, I am much better now.
It's okay.
Yeah. It's a great day for each one of you because some of you have been waiting for this day to happen. I was nostalgic when you all taking the pledge, every word of that pledge made me feel that how I missed this opportunity, right? You are super excited for this day. You have come all through the state and the states to be part of this. First, big round of applause to all of you for making this successful in your journey. It's a sheer dedication, the spirit, the energy, the hard work, and phenomenal patience that 4 years of journey you have made, and you deserve this. Second round of applause to all your parents who have been the sponsor of this program, taking care of you. Big round of applause to all of them. Wherever your parents are there, let them receive this love, receive this respect for the phenomenal sacrifice they make in their childs. The last big round of applause to all the respected teachers who have made you today what you are to the world. Big round of applause. Thank you so much. You may be seated. Respected Dr. Siddharamayaji, your most darling principal, Dr. Ashwathji, respected teachers, respected parents, the team Digital Media, and my dearest distance. the people belong to the digital world. You make the world what it is today. I'm extremely happy to be part of today's event, share a few thoughts as part of the graduation day organized by one of the pioneering institutions in the state of Karnataka, Bangalore Institute of Technology. I have been associated with this institution for many reasons. Dr. Ashwath mentioned about the Mission 10X, my brainchild. When you started that, I think many professors have been part of this program, as well as the students who have been with Provides for many, many years. Respected TPO sir was mentioning, even in the current batch completed, our national talent hunt, there are more than 40 plus people have been selected to Wipro. Hearty congratulations to all of them if you are part of this and you have been, going to join next year. Graduation day is a most memorable thing in anybody's life. Not for one reason, that you wear a gown, you take a lot of selfies, you throw a hat, and you recall all the 4 years of your life in the hostel and the campuses. I think very interesting book written by Subrata Bakshi, our first CEO as well. He's a Wipro product. So Wiproids are like that. Wherever they go, they create the world just like Wipro. So the popular book he has written, Kiss the World, it's a simple advice given by his mother to him. You also go and kiss the Mother Earth, not just the world. The moment you take the pause, you will all feel that I have to kiss somebody else. Kiss is very simple, K-I-S-S. K is knowledgeable. Be knowledgeable wherever you are. Get all that is required to be proficient, competent. That knowledge comes from all the 360 degree angles. You're from books, digital world, social media, friends, parents, and everybody who talks about their own experiences. I is innovation. Innovation is not the discovery. Innovation is redefining, redesigning, recreating the world that was existing, not for today, for the future. Be innovative technologically, be innovative socially, be innovative psychophysically. In today's rapidly changing digital transformation, being innovative makes you more entrepreneur, not just an employee. The focus should be becoming more and more entrepreneurs. Thanks to BIT producing so many entrepreneurs, first generation, I could see some of them are the chairpersons of some of the startups. Aim at becoming an entrepreneur, an innovative leader, helping the society at large. Being in BIT, definitely you will get a job and you will prosper across the globe. But thinking about the society, thinking of the end user, a common man will help our common human as well. It's very important for you to get the day, get the time, and get the knowledge out of you to create the wonders for the world, because you are special in this universe. The third letter, yes. Yes is always be skilled. In the entire digital transformation, every single day, thousands of jobs are created. 20 years back, if you're having one software engineer, people used to look at what is the meaning of the software engineer. The people only knew civil engineer, mechanical engineer, to extent possible electrical engineers. In 90s and the early part of the 21st century, people used to see the software engineer, computer science engineer, what is the engineering, you do it. But today, the computer science has become integral part of everybody's life. In the last 20 months of pandemic, every common person used the technology and enjoyed the power of information technology and information technology enabled services. And you are entering that world which brings dreams of the dreams, the reality of the reality, and the uncertainty of the uncertainty. You are entering that world. I am sure that those who completed a degree last year, you have been working in some companies and you have been understanding the importance of upskilling cross-skilling and reskilling. So the third letter in the KISS is skilling, reskilling, upskilling, cross-skilling and multi-skilling. The learning is a very important activity in everybody's life. The learning word, if you remove the first letter from learning, what is everyone wants to be aspired to? We want to earn. Don't focus on earning, just focus on learning, and learning has that earning embedded in it. The last letter of the KISS is S, which is about sensitivity. Whether you are in a personal life, professional life, or in the society, being sensitive to somebody is a great quality. Insensitivity is disrespecting behavior in the entire world. The human life, the student life, working life should be solidly built on the sensitivity. Sensitivity is not just being polite. It is being kind, warmful, helpful, listening, and respecting every individual, irrespective of their backgrounds, perspective, gender, and the state. That sensitivity takes you to places. If you are not sensitive, you create a stress for yourself. That stress is not healthy stress. When the stress is not healthy, it impacts your psychophysical system. KISS is basically be knowledgeable, be innovative, be skilled continuously, each time, every time, each day, every day, and sensitivity being a phenomenal transformation. The digital transformation world today offers phenomenal opportunities for each and every graduate. I am sure that those who have been working for the last 1 year or a few months in the industries, you have seen the dynamic, ever-changing opportunities that come into. The technology curve that was transforming every 6 years, over the last 6 years has come down to only 3 months. What you learn today, after 3 months, you will not have that technology as so relevant. So writing a set of skills in your resume at the beginning of the job, after 3 months, you certainly have to change the resume. That's the stage at which we are in. Constantly changing skill requirement means you need to be always have your radar on, your antenna tuned to what is the next technology going to impact the entire humanity. So Dr. Ashwath, you are mentioning about the future skills. The future skills is no longer the future skill, which is already integral part of every services and the solution industry has been providing. In 92-94, I used to teach artificial intelligence for engineering college students. That time people used to think, what is the use of artificial intelligence, right? Some of you have also taught computer science professors, you know, introduction to artificial intelligence. Today, every application, every device has artificial intelligence built in. Over 26 billion devices, as in today, are connected under IoT principles. It's continued to grow up to 75 billion devices by 2035. We are going to live in a world which is completely monitored by the devices. The moment you enter the gate opens, I think you have already seen. The moment you go inside the door, every devices talk to you. So that's the world you are. It is no longer the fiction, it is a real world. You know, last January 26th, now I supposed to go for a flag hoisting. Alexa was telling my wife, Mr. Kotur, you have to get up early in the morning. Because previous night I was talking to my wife that tomorrow I have to get up early in the morning because I have to travel to Electron City. It is recorded my voice and it is alerting that you have to get up in the morning. So devices are there around to listen to you what you speak. Your privacy is not yours. Your privacy is digital today. So maintaining the privacy in current digital world no longer is protected. It is public. Those who have studied object-oriented training, you know, learning programs, you have studied the protections like access control, private, public, protected. Your privacy is completely public. because every application that you use show you to the world who you are, what are your taste, what is the trend that you follow. That's the world we all belong to. We are going to witness phenomenal job opportunities in artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data analytics. The employment opportunities, digital talent area, the recruitment area across the globe is estimated to grow from $22 billion to $33 billion. It's a huge, huge opportunity for each one of you. Out of 4.4 million IT-enabled engineers working in India, roughly about 2.1 come from Karnataka alone. Out of 194 billion NASSCOM projected IT-enabled growth for India, 60 to 70% comes from Karnataka. So you are part of this ecosystem. I'm sure that there is a huge, huge opportunity for everyone who have a right skill. And you are entering that world. Currently at artificial intelligence and machine learning developers, there are 300,000, roughly about 3 lakh people in the world. We are expected to have opportunities for about 1 million exclusive AI and ML developers. Look at the opportunities in every field. If I list how many job opportunities going to create in artificial intelligence, big data analytics, IoTs, cyber security, and so on and so forth, it is a phenomenal, phenomenal transformation that is happening. One important thing each day, every day, you need to understand that what are the things I need to do to prosper my life, create myself for not only for my life, for the world. Only one mantra is the great quality each of us should wear is learnability. The more you learn, the more you earn. The more you earn, the more you donate. The more you donate, the more happy you will become. The story of the tree is very important at this moment because you are graduating, you have grown up, you are going to work, and you already started working in the industries. When the tree grows, it never thinks about it. It only does two things. One is continuously deepening under the ground and continuously blossoming outside the world. For each one of us, just emulating the principles of the trees, that I need to deepen my understanding, deepen my own strength, deepen my own standing in the world. The deeper the roots go, the stronger you become. The more you learn, the more competent you become. When look at the external world, where the tree gives you branches, leaves, flowers, fruits, the outcome of education, outcome of work should be to give something back to the society. That gives you satisfaction. Over the last 21 years, I have been privileged, I am blessed to go around the country and across the globe to address more than 350,000, 3.5 lakh engineering graduates, help them to grow in the industries. I have seen some of them have become entrepreneurs, some of them become advisors to governments, both in India and outside. I am sure that you will also become like that. And when you look at the other aspect of human life is to being character-based person. One is a competence, another is a character. Character is not just the glory that person carries. Character is basically what you are, how you are made of, and why your existence for the world. I think thanks to doctor who given the pledge, it says, I want to be loyal, I want to be honest, I don't want to be corrupt. Corrupt is not necessarily transacting the money. Corruption starts here. Thinking ill about yourself, thinking ill about somebody, not studying well, not helping others is also corruption. Our mind, our body, and soul needs to develop a finer aspect of the humanity. My third point is B class, not class B. In anything and everything you do, B class. Be a class means always stylish, global, responsible, and you are a person of character. Character gives you a global identity. Character gives you fame, name, and character gives you huge amount of opportunities coming in your way. The last important point I would like to, you know, share and conclude my address is all about being worthy student, worthy child, worthy spouse, and a worthy citizen. May I request for some time? When you say individual, you are here for the purpose. The purpose is not to just become a job holder. It's a purpose to become a leader. Leader is one who is not only continuously growing, the leader is also continuously shining the ecosystem he or she belongs to. The leader is one who lifts other, not shifts other. So while you start working for the world, while you continuously grow both technologically, emotionally, socially, and health-wise, you also need to bring the best out of you to the world to create the best people around you. Being yourself best helps to some extent, but if you create the best around you, it creates the holistic society to make a livable planet. Therefore, our unwavering commitment to the planet, communities, the society we all belong to, it is a greater responsibility on each one of us to create a very amicable living standards for not only for us, our families, but for the people around us. The second important message part of is, once you move out of the individual, you have the family. Family means your near and dear ones. You have been here in the campus, you are going to work in India, you possibly may travel outside. Wherever you are, be in touch with your parents and your loved ones. Thanks to technology, technology helps you to connect every single day. Share the good feeling, not the tick mark. I need to connect with my parents, I need to connect with my friend, connect with the teacher. Not for the tick mark, for the heart mark. So you have to connect with each one of them. Create that homeliness, warmful relationship. Individual, society, that means family, then comes the society. Society is all about what has created us today. We have learned from the society. We have learned from the neighbors. We have learned from the governments. We have learned from the organizations. And we learned from the institutions. Giving back our valuable time to those institutions should be paramount behavior. So as Dr. Ashwath mentioned about some of the alumnus, come back, spend time with each one of you. My sincere request to each one of you to come back once in a while. If you are all in Bangalore, you can definitely make a time. One Saturday, spend 1 hour with 5 engineering students. Give them your learning experience. How has been your life in the corporate? What are your learnings? How the gap that existed during your college days as well as in the current working, how you have shaped up your life, what are the challenges you are facing, how you got into problem solving, how you are getting into the global citizenship, that will inspire them. They know how to learn, what to learn, from where to learn. But your help to your junior will definitely inspire. The last is the country. The country that we all belong has been protecting us, our soldiers, our defense forces, our leaders have given phenomenal protection each day. We do not understand how protected we are, how safe we are in the hands of our border forces. Contribute to the country to protect our generations, our next generations, by being helpful both socially, digitally, nationally, emotionally, and ecologically. Hearty congratulations to each one of you. All the very best. Welcome to the world of corporate. Thank you very much.
As a token of gratitude. It is now time for the release of the much-awaited Coffee Table Book. Coffee Table Book being released today will forever etch in our memories as it is one of the kind being released for the first time in the history of BIT. Coffee Table Book glorifies the achievements and memories of the students during their journey at BIT. It is a souvenir for all those graduating in 2019-20 and 2020-21 to cherish, relish their achievements and memories at BIT. May I now kindly request our chief guest, Sri P.B. Kottu, to release the Coffee Table Book. I kindly request all the dignitaries on the dais to join, please. This is the release of the Coffee Table Book 2020-21. Along with the Coffee Table Book, we are delighted to release the annual magazine on an annual college magazine, Britannica. The college magazine is intended to arcade and present the academic achievements of faculty members and students of BIT, information on various technical and cultural events conducted at BIT during the previous academic year. May I request all the dignitaries on the dais to release the annual magazine, Britannica 2021, digitally. Thank you all. Now is the time to felicitate those talents who have portrayed academic excellence throughout and through perseverance and hard work have brought pride to this institution. I hand over the stage to Professor Navaneet Nataraj, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, to lead the guests to honor these outstanding talents.
Thank you, Bhargavi Madam, and very good morning to one and all present here. So I would like to call upon gold medalists and rank holders of the year 2019-2020. Vidya GS from the Department of Electrical and Electronics, who secured first rank and the gold medal. Please come on the stage. Rajeshwari GL from the Department of Digital Electronics and Communication from MTech ENC, who secured first rank and gold medal. Okay. Shalini J, who secured first rank and gold medal from the Department of Signal Processing MTech. Rani K, who secured first rank and gold medal from the Department of Computer Networking. Next, Ranjita MS from the Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, who secured second rank. Anurag Muniraj from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, who secured second rank. C. Sanjana from the Department of IEM. Next, Trivedi THM, third rank from MTech Computer Networking. Next, Samanvit KM, who secured fourth rank from the Department of IEM. Next, Smita GM from the Department of Information Science, who secured fourth rank. Next, Prakruti C from MTech Computer Science, who secured fourth rank. Next, Suchitra S from the Department of Electronics and Communication, who secured fifth rank. Ankita P from the Department of IEM, who secured fifth rank. So we have Prakruti on stage now. Next, Krutika Madhusudana. We have Ankita on stage now from the Department of IEM, who secured fifth rank. Krutika Madhusudana from Department of IEM. Next, Nagasaujanya N from the Department of Telecommunication Engineering, who secured seventh rank. We have Krutika's parents to collect the mementos. Sorry for the inconvenience. So we have Krutika's parent to collect the mementos. Next, Vinay EY from the Department of Electrical and Electronics. Yeah, we have Naga Saujanya on stage now. Vinay EY. Next, Penugonda Manasa Nandini. Kalyani Upadhyay. Sushma MP. Okay, we have Vinay EY on stage from the Department of Electrical and Electronics, who secured ninth rank. Congratulations, all the rank holders of 2019 and 20 batch. Now I would like to call upon rank holders of 2020 and 21. Seema R. Hegde from the Department of Electrical and Instrumentation, who secured first rank and the gold medal. Priya Rao from the Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, who secured second rank. We have Priya Rao on stage. Next, Nisha K from the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication, who secured second rank from M-Tech. So we have Nisha on stage, who secured second rank from the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication. Next, Sonika K from the Department of Electronics and Instrumentation, who secured third rank. So we have Sonika from the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication. Electronics and Instrumentation. Next, I would like to call Vivek S. Hiremat from the Department of IEM, who secured fourth rank. Vivek on stage now. Next, I would like to call Kruthika KR from Information Science, who secured sixth rank. We have Kruthika KR on stage now from the Department of Information Science. Next, I would like to call Roja P from Telecommunication Engineering, who secured sixth rank. So we have Roja on stage now from the Department of Telecommunication Engineering. Next, I would like to call Minchu S. Prakash from the Department of Electrical and Electronics, who secured eighth rank. Next, I would like to call Prem Kumar from Computer Network, M-Tech. Next, I would like to call Payal from the Department of Information Science and Engineering. On behalf of Prem Kumar. Next, I would like to call Mohanamala DL from Telecommunication Engineering, who secured eighth rank. Next, I would like to call Farheen Khan from M-Tech Computer Science, who secured eighth rank. Now we have Mohana Mala on stage from the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication. Next, I would like to call Neha Nadigar from the Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, who secured 10th rank. Thank you. Now we have Neha Nadigar from the Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, who secured 10th rank. Next we have Tejas MS. We have Tejas parents to collect the mementos in spite of him. He's from the Department of Electronics and Instrumentation, who secured 7th rank. Now I would like to call upon PhD awardees from various departments of BIT. So PhD awardees from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, we have Dr. Girija J, and year of completion 2019. Next, I would like to call upon Dr. Harish Kumar BT from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, and year of completion 2019. We have Dr. Harish Kumar sir on the stage now. I request all the other teachers to come close to the stage as I call the names. Next, I would like to call Dr. B.N. Shankar Gowda from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, year of completion 2020. And also Dr. Savita S.K. from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Now we have Dr. Shankar Gowda from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Dr. Savita S.K. from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, year of completion 2020. Next, I would like to call from the Department of Information Science and Engineering, Dr. Vani V, year of completion 2019. Next, Dr. Rupa H, year of completion 2020. Dr. Shivakumar BR, year of completion 2020. Dr. C.S. Jayashila, year of completion 2020. We'd also like to call external candidates from the Department of Information and Science and Engineering, Dr. Maina and Dr. Hema Malini. Now we have Dr. Shivakumar BR on stage. Now we have Dr. C.S. Jayashila on stage. Dr. Maina from the Department of Information Science and Engineering. We have Dr. Maina on stage. Dr. Hema Malini. Now I would like to call upon Dr. Jalaja S. from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Doctor of Philosophy awarded with the Department Electrical and Electronics Engineering. I would also request Dr. Vijay Prakash sir and Dr. Hemant Kumar sir from the Department of Electronics and Communication to join Dr. Jalaja S. We have Dr. Jalaja S. on stage. Next, Doctor of Philosophy in Mechanical Engineering Department, Dr. Praveen Kumar MR, year of completion 2019. Next, Dr. Vasant Kumar R, Year of completion 2019. Now we have Dr. Praveen Kumar on stage. And Dr. Umesh GL from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, year of completion 2020. Congrats. Dr. Umesh GL. Now I would like to call all the toppers of individual departments who secured first and second place group wise. Toppers of civil department, please get ready to come on stage in group wise. So from Civil Department Engineering, Rushi Sri, Murali S, Gagana HN, Ramya M, Yashasvi R, Arun VS, Velkur Dharani, Nikhil Sagar. Please come on stage. And also we have Ramya RE, Rushi Sri, Murali S, Radha V, Vijay Lakshmi TK, Sandeep S, Rakshita Nag, Anusha VS. I request all of you to come along with your certificates on stage, please. And also Preeti S, Gagana HN, Rachana RT, and Ramya M from Department of Civil Engineering. All the department toppers of Civil Engineering, please assemble on stage along with your certificates. We have all the toppers from 2019 and 2020 on stage. Next, I would request the students from Mechanical Engineering to get ready to come on stage, both 2019 and 2020 batch. Now I would request mechanical engineering students of 2019-20 batch to come on stage along with the cumulative toppers. Adarsh Anand, Samrud Mude, Samarth Chakraborty, Chandan Kumar BC, Raghav Sharma, Chetan GS, Deepak, Kunal Sahu, Ashish Vinod. Kindly come along with your mementos on stage. I request all of you to please make it fast. Also, I would like to request 2020 batch students to come. Abhishek G, Samrud Mude, Ashish Vinod, Chaitra, Prabhat P. Rao, Shrisha KV, Karthik Dhadwal, Krishna G, Shrikant Ramanayak. Please come on stage quickly. Alago. So we have students of 2019-20 batch on stage from the Department of Mechanical Engineering. Adika. 2021 batch students. Next, I would like to call students of Electrical and Electronics Engineering branch to come on stage. Gaurav Bharti, Ravindra KN, Chandana Deepthi, Samyukta M, Rachana Jain K, Karthik Singh R, Nandini D, Sahil Kochar, Rachana Jain, Bindu H, Samyukta M, Ravindra KN, Minchu Prakash, Chandana Deepthi M. Please come on the stage along with your mementos. Next, I would like to call Electronics and Communication Engineering students to get ready for the stage. Be ready with your mementos. Students of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Mithun BV, Kirtana K, Bolupalle Shravya Shri, Divya T, Nisarga, Parthiv Kamath S, Ritika M, Srinivas Kanadikar, Ariba, Dilip K, Chetan RD, Varsha Ganeshan, Prapti Prasad, Yeruva Venkata Sai Bhanu, Apurva A, Sanjana S, Navneet S, Afreen Kubra, Divya T, Anisha Nisarga. Kindly come on stage with your mementos. We have students of Electronics and Communication Engineering Department. Next, I would like to request Computer Science students to get ready along with your mementos. Next, from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Kushwant Kumar, D.V. Lasya, Revant P.N., Gausia Farheen Taj, Akhori Saumya, Sneha Tiwari, Vishal D. Bhatt, Sonia K. John, Chanchal Chauhan, Darshan A.M., Sushilai Bhatt, Shreya K.R., Vishnupriya, Akhori Saumya, Lasya D.V., S.B. Ambika, Ananya B.N., Revant P.N., Farheen Khan and Sonia K. John. Kindly get ready to come on stage along with your mementos. Now we have students from the Computer Science and Engineering Department. Next, I would like to call Electronics and Instrumentation Department students to get ready with your mementos and come on stage. So next, from the Department of Electronics and Instrumentation, I would like to call Pradyumna M, Jeevagan RG, Ritvik Banerjee, Swati KJ, Mahesh Reddy, Dhanya S, Rakshita Rajashekara, Pradyumna N, Vismaya Prasad. Then Seema R, Ritvik Banerjee. Kindly come on stage along with your mementos. Now we have students from Electronics and Instrumentation Department. Next, I would like to call students from IEM branch, Industrial Electronics and Management, Industrial Engineering and Management, to get ready. So from IEM, I would like to request Deepa BV, Spandana K, Kirtana M Mane, Deepa BV, Ananya HK, Monisha S, Chaitra S, then Nikita Jain, Swati MC. We would also like to request from the Department of Structural Engineering, MTech, Sandeep C. Raikar to come on stage. I would like to request everybody to give a big round of applause. Now we have Sandeep C. Raikar, who secured second position from the Department of Civil Engineering, Structural Engineering. I would also like to call BB Asia from the Department of Electronics and Communication, MTech Digital Electronics and Communication, to come on stage, who secured first rank in VTU. Now we have Sandeep C. Raikar on stage. Now we have BB Asia from MTech Digital Electronics and Communication. Next, I would like to request students of Electronics and Telecommunication Department to assemble on stage. I request all the students to stay in the auditorium until the program is over. Kindly don't leave the hall. Next, I would like to call.
Hello. I request everybody to please be seated. Don't leave the auditorium. We will wind up the event in a couple of maybe 10 minutes. Please bear with us. And if you are leaving, some of the parents, we have arranged for a small snack. Please collect it at the entrance, please. Students, ensure that your parents get the snacks. And all the other graduating students, your snacks are arranged in your departments. Please collect it from there if you haven't already done.
And now we have students of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering on stage. C. Aparna, Vanshika Sharma, Nayana, Ahalya, Ashika Gupta, Nitya Shri, Jagadisha, Elvin Paul, Akanksha Kumari, Sujana, Sahana J, Sanjana V. Gujjar, and Shreshra Anil Kumar. Next, I would like to call students student toppers from the Department of Instrumentation, sorry, Department of Information Sciences and Engineering. Students from Information Science and Engineering, please come on stage. So we have students from Information Science and Engineering, Danush Kanchi, Yuvika Ramesh Babu, Bhavana SN, Sneha R, Kushal AC, Ritviz Ranjan, Sushum R, Divya Rani. And Kushal AC, Yuvika Ramesh, Bhavana SN, Gautami R, Harsha Kumari, Sneha A, Aishwarya S, Sonali NK. Next, I would like to call upon Afreen Kubra, who secured first rank in VTO MTech Digital Electronics and Communication. Please give her a big round of applause, everyone. Next, I would like to call upon student toppers from AI and ML, Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning. And I kindly request all students not to play whistle. So from the Department of AI and ML, we have Kollipara Sai Sandeep and Vignesh RS. Next, I would like to request students from MBA to get ready to come on stage. So from Department of MBA, I would like to request Nivetita Shri, Sushil Kumar S, Santosh SS, and Madhavi JR from the Department of MBA. Next, I would also like to request students from MCA to get ready. All of you kindly be seated and please don't leave the hall until the program is over. Thank you. Now we have student toppers from MBA department on stage. Next, student toppers from MCA, please get ready. Anusha HC, Akshata NR, Kirtana P, Purnima MC, Amruta Sindhu, Preetam GP, Akshata NR, Shivani Raj, Kirti Krishna Bhatt. And also Manasa HJ, Ritu Satish, and Shivali from the Department of MCA. All of you, please give them a big round of applause. So thank you, everyone.
Thank you, dignitaries. Thank you, Professor Navneet Nataraj. And congratulations to all the rank holders, PhD holders, and merit awardees. The closing hour has finally arrived. However, your journey has just begun. The world is waiting for you to bestow great things upon it. Persist and persevere. Do not fear. Because if you believe in you, you will find dreams can come true. Congratulations to all graduates. May your knowledge carry you ahead. With this, I call Professor Tejaswini BM, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, to propose a vote of thanks.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Tejaswini BM, Assistant Professor in the Department of ECE, deem it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this memorable occasion. Gratitude is not only the greatest of all the virtues, but the parent of all others, says Cicero. Your past was never a mistake. If you learn from it, so take all the crazy experiences and lesson learned hard, put them all in a box labeled thank you. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a blessed success. First and foremost, I thank our special guest for today's event, Sri P.B. Kottur Sir, Head of Global Freshers Engagement Program, Wipro Limited. Global Goodwill Ambassador, who despite his busy schedule has found time to grace this occasion. I also extend my heartfelt thanks to Sri Karigowda Sir, IAS, Administrator Rajavakkaligara Sangha, for his support. We are also grateful to Dr. C. Siddharamaya Sir, KGS, CEO Rajavakkaligara Sangha, and Dr. Narasimhamurthy KH, Advisor Rajavakkaligara Sangha, for their support and encouragement. Events like this do not happen overnight. It requires a lot of planning, vision, and I thank our visionary and well-wisher, Dr. M.U. Ashwath Sir, Principal BIT, for his guidance, hospitality, and continued support. Now, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the backbone of this event, all the coordinators of various committees for their hard work and commitment. Dr. Swarnalata Ma'am, Dr. Shankar Gowda Sir, Dr. Hemant Kumar Sir, Dr. Sri Rangaraju Sir, Dr. Nagesh H.B., Dr. Vijay Kumar T. Sir, Dr. Jalaja S. Ma'am, Professor Shobha Y. Ma'am, Professor Rangappa S. Sir, Dr. Bhargavi M.S. Ma'am, Professor Niranjan E. Sir, and Professor Harshavardhan. My heartfelt thanks to heads of various departments, faculties, both teaching and non-teaching, for their support and encouragement throughout the event. I owe a special thanks to all the parents and the students who have made time and graced us with their presence. Indeed, we are very grateful to you people. Thank you, one and all, who have either directly or indirectly lent a helping hand for the smooth conduction of such a magnificent event. Now, I request all the audience, dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, to please rise up for the national anthem.
సార్ ఒక నిమిషం సార్ నీవిరి